Hello everyone. So let's begin our last part of this poem, The Voice of the Rain, written by Walt Whitman. First of all, we shall get the setting of the poem. There are two settings of this poem. The first one is wherever the speaker is while standing amidst the soft falling shower, which speaks back to them. And the second setting is the entire earth. The central idea of this poem is, the poem signifies the eternal role that the rain plays in nurturing, quenching, nourishing, and purifying the various elements of the earth. The rain returns the favor to its place of origin, from where it rises unseen from the depths of the water and from the land. The rain itself is explaining to the reader about its origin, work, and its cyclic movement. Theme of the poem. What is meant by theme? Theme means background of anything. So the major thing of the poem is rain and its natural cycle. Because the poem has been written keeping in the mind that rain is important to give life on the earth, and its natural cycle gives a continuity of the life on the earth. Tone of the poem. What is meant by tone? Tone is an element of the poem where the poet expresses his feelings and emotion in the poem. So the poem is written in blank verse and has no any specific metrical pattern and rhyme scheme. The tone of the poem is conversational in nature because the rain is expressing its work and function. This method has an advantage as it helps to maintain the continuity of thoughts and ideas of the poet, and also brings clarity and vividness in expression. The rain is the speaker and has been personified. Let us discuss the literary devices used in the poem. The first one is personification, because the rain has been personified in the poem. The second is metaphor, because the rain compares itself to the poem of the earth. It says that I am the poem of the earth. Then the third is simile or parallelism, because in the last two lines the poet has drawn a parallel between the rain and the song of a poet. So it is called simile or parallelism. Then the fourth one is hyperbole. The poet used hyperbole in the words bottomless sea. So here, bottomless sea is an example of hyperbole, as the poet describes sea as bottomless, which is an exaggerated statement to bring out the desired effect. Then imagery. Imagery is used in the word soft falling shower, because in the first line of the poem, soft falling shower gives the reader an image of gentle rain or drizzle. During the dialogue between the poet and the rain, it creates an image of shower or drops of water falling down from the heavens to earth and infusing it with greenery, purity, and beauty. And then extended metaphor, as I have explained it in the part 2 video. However, let us discuss about this. The rain is compared to the poem of the earth, and it has been extended through the all lines with multiple sentences and ideas in the poem, which is interlinked to each other. So this was our last video of the poem. Thank you very much, and I hope that you will make a well-maintained notes on it.